How do you do?
Just a word of friendly warning. I think it will thrill you. It may shock you. It might even horrify you. So if any of you feel that you do not care to subject your nerves to such a strain, now is your chance to, well, reform you.
Welcome to this new episode.
That's the theme of this week.
the theme of sickness.
We're down with the sickness.
So it's just going to be three of us today. My name's Amy. I have Andy here.
Hi.
I have Freddy.
Hey.
Kelley. What does he have?
We don't know.
Parasites in his bottom.
Monsters inside him.
At least had to text us. Kelley is so sick, he couldn't text us.
Yeah.
Or his phone is probably dead. That's why.
Could be either or, yeah.
No, Mikey B is not sick. He's so tired.
Yeah.
He's sleepy.
We had a long night last night.
We did. We went to a haunt with our friend Tony Wilson, who's visiting.
Hey, Tony.
I'm sorry I missed you, because I was sick last night.
Mm. He's a sweetheart.
Sick of fucking leaving the house.
Mm.
So the haunt you went to, tell me about it.
Okay.
It apparently had a pee-pee maze in it.
Uh-huh. It's called the Highway 50 Fright Field.
It's right down the street from the cabana.
Oh, cabanas. Yeah.
So listeners, you should know, if you know where the cabana is.
Well, it's called cabanas. It's not called Kroger's. It's called Kroger.
Hey, our show is like littered through.
It's not Walmart's.
It's littered with local talk throughout. Okay. So if you listen to the show, you get an idea of what Cincinnati's like.
Yes. Yeah.
So this 19th century farm, and also it's a Native American archaeological dig site.
So they didn't build on top of the...
For real.
They built adjacent too.
Right.
They were actually selling quote unquote Native American artifacts.
Oh, arrowheads, yeah. Tomahawks.
Oh no.
But they also have this great like queue experience through the gift shop.
It's very Disney themed.
Yeah. There's all kinds of stuff from all over the world as far as like voodoo dolls, shrunken heads.
It's like a cabin of curiosities basically.
Yeah. Yep. Is it the mystery spot?
Yeah.
From Gravity Falls. Uh-huh. I said that's what it reminded me of.
Was it spooky?
Yeah, especially when you turn the corner and all of a sudden you see all these signed pictures of the cast of the Dukes of Hazzard behind the register.
For real?
Yeah.
Oh.
Then you're like,
okay. It's an unusual juxtaposition.
Andy, how many times did you fall down?
Well, not because I was scared. I slipped once because I'm just clumsy.
They got me a few times there.
I got the clumsies.
And it's pretty rare for Freddy to get got.
I think what did it at this particular haunt is it's all outdoors, and the first portion of it's through a cornfield, which gives you ample areas to jump out from.
A lot of hidey holes.
Right. It's not like a constructed haunt where you know what corners to look for. And also, they were very good at misdirection. And they're...
They were very good at the games, like, is he real?
Oh, I know.
Yeah.
You know the is he real
game?
That's
what I do... In every haunt, I yell at the thing. Yeah. Are you real?
And then it helped because it was so dark in there. But they were also very good at miming animatronics.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So like, you know, you walk past them and then they just jump out at you and get you real good.
Yeah, it was very dark, and they give one person in your group a little flashlight.
Yeah.
And that's how you that's go through. You And Andy was our guy. He was our leader.
Oh, dear.
But they gave me a fleshlight. It was gross.
Yeah.
Did it light up?
Yeah.
Oh, that's good.
So you can jerk off in the dark.
Sure.
Felt real enough, I guess.
Yeah. Have I ever told you about Mikey B's advice? And it was really good advice. It's like if you're wondering if it's a real person or like a fake person, mannequin or whatever in a haunt, look at their hands. Mm-hmm. More often than not, the fake ones will have flat hands because they didn't like give them
fully like articulation.
Fleshed
you want to know who didn't know what was real or fake last night?
What?
Mikey B.
Oh, well, he doesn't listen to his own goddamn advice.
Yeah, they got him and me both.
Physician, heal thyself.
The one who was
a trick in there.
Drinking out of the bowl over and over again. That guy was really startled the shit out of us.
So the pee-pee maze, I heard you peed in the maze.
Well, it's a two-parter thing. You get the haunt trail and then a corn maze, which is like also super dark. That's, they give you a flashlight, which doesn't help you at all.
Right.
And you get lost real easy.
And then if you have to urinate, apparently you just do it.
Well, yeah, you have to just go off into the corn and you pee.
Children of the corn are going to come find your ass.
I heard like Malachi go, ew.
Dude, you're splashing on my shoes.
There was a, we passed a family in that corn maze that said they'd been in there for hours.
And you think it was just like, they work there and they're just like, we're flavor.
Their job is to wander around lost.
Well, if they were just workers, they were very good at faking their panic.
Yeah.
They were in a panic.
That's kind of fun, though. I would love to get lost in a corn maze.
Oh, you should have come.
Oh.
You could have peed in the dead end, too.
Was Law & Order True Crime The Menendez Murders going to watch itself?
No. It's incapable of that. It's also incapable of empathy.
Yeah.
Yeah. Can you imagine that in the corn maze? It'll still be there.
The Menendez brothers jump out.
You never loved us! You're a horrible father! Oh, my Lord Almighty.
Then all the ladies would be like, hey, I like you.
There was a, they have a section of the haunt portion that is like classic horror. Mm-hmm. So they had Elm Street in the middle of the corn. They had
Michael Myers
in the middle of the corn.
How do you have these things in the middle of the corn? Don't tell me.
It's fun. There's something surreal about it.
It was so...
Just all of a sudden there's a street sign?
It was a weird...
there was an Elm Street sign.
I don't know if there's a storyline in that maze because they gave us a spiel before we went in about how Stony Fields?
I don't know.
Harry Fields.
Oh, the guy, Seymour Fields.
Seymour Fields.
Yeah, he wanted to go out and see more of his fields.
Yeah. And then his wife got pissed off at him and killed him.
Yeah.
And is that right? I thought he just died out there.
No, she said she killed him, I think.
No.
Guys.
I think Andy wasn't.
Let people go experience it. Yeah. What was it called again?
It's called Highway 50 Fright Field.
Mm-hmm. Fright Field. Never heard of it before. That's awesome though. We found a new one.
Yeah.
It's a good deal too. $15 for two things.
That's crazy.
Oh, it was only 15. I couldn't remember exactly how much we paid.
Of course not.
Of course not. And then there was the Children of the Corn in the corn, which made sense.
Right. That. Yes.
And they did a good job with that. They had the blue man and they had all the signs.
He was by himself. He was not in a group.
Yeah. And
I love dad jokes.
I love the Blue Man Group. Jason Voorhees. It was very much like Freddy versus Jason with the party in the cornfield.
Yeah.
And they did a good job
but
of that.
But it was a weird section where they had an Egyptian tomb.
Didn't it feel like a dream because you're out in the cornfield and all of a sudden you wander into these scenes?
And you had done ayahuasca earlier.
Yeah.
I just felt like, hey, what's scary?
What's scary here?
And they just tossed everything that they Googled scary.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And they just tossed all the results into the field.
I'm okay with that. Listen, haunts don't, I mean, you know what I mean?
It was good. I'm not saying it wasn't good, but
throw it at the wall. Let's have some fun.
Yeah. But you just walked from like the Egyptian section right into the redneck section.
Well, that's weird.
Mm-hmm.
So that was weird. It's like time travel.
Well, I'm glad you guys had fun.
How much reality TV did you watch last night
Only watched one episode because I was watching the Menendez Murders, and then I watched Patton Oswalt's new special. And then I was like, I can watch one episode of Real Housewives of New Jersey before bed.
Didn't you finish that already, or are you going through the second time?
This is a season that hit Hulu after I had stopped.
You have to watch it twice to catch all the Easter eggs.
Oh, my God. Yeah,
it's very
subtle. You can make fun of me all you want.
All the subtleties. I'm not making fun of you.
I understand
why. You watch what you want.
I love it, though.
I like it. I mean, there's no there's no shame in that. I think Real Housewives is great entertainment.
I'm judging you while not judging you.
I mean, listen, I judge myself, but I'm like, whatever. I likes what I likes.
Well, I always say, like, I don't have any guilty pleasures. Like, I watch what I want.
Mm-hmm. I'll tell anybody, too. Like, yeah. This is... My one fear, though, is I'll be called for jury duty. And it's something I think I'd really not enjoy, but you know what I mean? Like, I want to do once in my life, and I've never been called. But they're going to be like, so, you know, prosecutors and, you know, defense, they don't really want people that are big into true crime because we all insist on forensic evidence or whatever, and that's just not the real world. And they're going to be like, so, you know, do you watch any of these things? And I'm going to be like, fucking constantly. It's goddamn true crime all the time.
Yeah.
And they're not going to want me. But anyway.
Would they weed you out because of that or because of your housewife addiction?
Oh. All I know is I am a defense lawyer's dream. Because I'm like, well, there's lots of reasonable doubt there. That's some reasonable doubt. That's plenty of reasonable doubt. Oh, there's always reasonable doubt.
Well, if they're going to throw people out by judging by what they watch, I'd be tossed out because I watch Flavor of Love constantly.
Oh. Still constantly. Keep going back. How many seasons were there?
There's only 3 seasons, but on YouTube, there are, like, all the episodes are on there.
Is it comforting? You just kind of throw it on?
I just like throw an episode on, like,
do some laundry
before I go to bed, and it drifts me off to sleep, and I just...
Do you ever dream about Flavor Flav?
Ugh. No, I just dream of pumpkin spin in New York's face constantly.
Oh, yeah.
Freddie's been watching, before he goes to bed, an interesting little television show.
Hammer House of Horror. It's on Shudder.
Yep.
It's from 1980. It's like a horror anthology series that Hammer Studios made, and it's pretty great.
I find that to be good background while I'm reading before bed.
What, yeah. Like anthology series?
Yeah, it's like 13 episodes, anthology. Pretty original, unpredictable for the most part stories.
Some weird British nonsense.
Yeah.
I don't know.
So it's like a Hammer movie condensed into like a 10-minute segment?
Like 45 minutes. Mm,
okay. Like 45.
Like each episode, you know.
You know.
It's like an hour. It's like an hour,
Oh, we also went to see John Mulaney this weekend on Friday.
Yes, we saw John Mulaney, which it was really good.
We saw a lot of white people.
It was the whitest audience, but that was to be expected for a couple of reasons. It's the Aronoff, which is where we get all of our Broadway on the road shows. So, I mean, let's be real. And then it was John Mulaney, but at least his opener, Max Silvestri, kind of acknowledged that. Which I thought was really funny. He was very funny.
Yeah, they were both really good. Like, long show too. I was surprised because I'm only used to seeing a comedian do an hour bit because of Netflix.
Right.
So when he went over an hour, I'm like, what's going on? I need to watch something else.
Get your phone out, start playing Candy Crush, and you're like, whoa, wait a minute! I paid like $40 for this.
I'm just waiting for it to Netflix to like segue into the trailer. For something else when that ends. It's like, are you still watching? Yes, Netflix, I'm still watching.
Oh, thank you.
How dare you?
The usual bit, you have to, any visiting artist to Cincinnati, somebody has to mention the chili and how weird it is. Okay? And we got that. Max Silvestri's opener did that. Thank God, because otherwise I don't know what to do with myself. Somebody has to make fun of us for our Cincinnati chili.
Right.
You gotta.
You think they actually do try it, or they just know that it's a bit that will hit the audience?
It's a secret Facebook group only stand-ups have, and it's for every city, like a thing to make fun of.
Yeah. Actually, it's a note backstage at every venue.
That too.
It's easier that way.
That too.
And then they don't have to cross-reference anything. You're just like, all right, where am I? Okay. They eat dogs here.
Mm-hmm.
So then when they get to say, so St. Louis, you eat dogs. That's weird, right?
Y'all eat dogs. That's Pittsburgh and you know
Then when they eat shit.
Permanti Brothers putting fries on their sandwiches. What?
That's gross. I don't care for that. Also, other John Mulaney news. I finished Big Mouth and I'm so sad.
It is the cutest, most raunchiest thing ever.
Oh my God. It's so good. If you haven't watched it on Netflix yet, I'm mad at you. I'm sad. It was just really good, and there was only 10 episodes.
Just a warning, you see animated preteen genitalia.
Oh my God, constantly.
In the gym teacher's giant nipples through his wrestling singlet.
That definitely happened.
Because that's equal.
It's equally horrifying to me.
If you liked F is for Family, and you also enjoyed The Kroll Show and all that stuff, you're going to love Big Mouth. Watch Big Mouth.
And it's if you like a great cast, it's got one of the best casts I've ever seen. Seen.
Anytime I can have Jason Mantzoukas, I'm happy.
I think I need to oil Andy's chair. It's driving me fucking
insane. Oh, dear.
Am I squeaking?
It's creaking.
Do you want to oil him up?
You don't hear that?
You got to oil him up. You got to give him some oil.
Are you sure it's my chair?
Yeah, you were just creaking a minute ago. I don't know what you were doing to make it creak. There it goes.
There it goes.
No, when I rock, I think.
Oh. I want to rock right now.
So, I'm going to destroy Andy's chair. Okay. Man.
FYI.
That's where Murphy Brown worked.
FYE.
For your entertainment.
We're going to be doing another live show at the Overlook Lodge on October 30th.
Yeah.
It's a Monday night. 7:30?
Yes.
Come have a cocktail and listen to us talk about Halloween and the history and our own personal stories. Yeah,
come in costume.
Yeah.
It's going to be really fun. Costume. Like, do whatever you want.
Come in your costume. Yeah.
I'm not going to be wearing one because I don't usually do costumes.
Come dressed as a condom.
Yeah.
Come in your costume.
Brandon,
you kill him.
Kill him in 5:30. He said he's planning on coming in a costume.
That's Brandon Boone. Your friendly neighborhood composer.
Do you hear it?
From No Sleep.
I think that's your chair.
It's not my chair.
It's your chair.
No, it's definitely
I'm gonna
you.
Beat the shit out of you.
Okay, everybody beat rock. Shit everybody out of rock you. Right now.
Ooh. I want to rock
right
now. I'm
not rocking
now.
At all.
Okay. I'm rebased and I came to get down. I'm not internationally known. I think to rock a microphone.
So I think you probably want to enable the ability to recline in that chair is what you want. Because I think you're fighting it and that's what's making the noise.
So come join
there
us.
There it is. Did you hear it? Oh did you hear it just then?
Oh, the brand new chairs that we got are already showing their age.
Well, some of us need to lose some weight, Andy. The joke here is he's the tiniest person you've ever met. All right, so October 30th.
My middle name is Fatass.
Andy Fatass Hung.
Come join us, Fatass Hung. And he'll tell you all about our Halloween memories. October 30th, 7:30, Overlook Lodge, Cincinnati. That's in Pleasant Ridge. If you have any questions, concerns, thoughts, feelings you want me to send you, you want me to print out like a map quest and mail it to you, I can do that. Just email us, crew@notlp.com. Horror Hound Weekend Columbus is coming up.
It's going to be all Christmassy and shit.
At first, I was like, I can't go to 3 Horror Hounds.
Yeah. And now you're getting a little bit like FOMO.
Kind of like a little icky.
Yeah.
To want to go this because it seems so much fun.
We were going to be in Dollywood that weekend, so we will not be there. The three of us talking in this room right now, these human beings, plus Mikey B. But Kelly and Elise will be there. So go, have fun. They've got a really cool lineup. Like everybody from Friday 13th, what?
2?
5?
I feel like they're from 5? A bunch of them.
6?
A bunch of F-13s.
Some Gremlins people.
And an American Pie reunion.
A bunch of American Pie people. They're awesome event badges. For this show.
They've got a lot of really cool VIP stuff.
All the merchandise is really neat. Yeah.
Got some wrestlers going there.
Good photo ops, too. Jack Frost. You can get a photo op with the actual Jack Frost.
You can be nipping at your nose.
The Michael Keaton one?
No.
Nipping at your nose. Your little nose. So that's coming up, horrorhoundweekend.com for all that information. Also, patreon.com/notlp if you want to be a patron of this very program.
Mm-hmm.
Kick us a buck. Kick us 58
bucks. We went from 91 patrons to 90 patrons, and now we're back at 91.
Ooh. I told everybody, go send your money.
He opens a window.
You send your money to Puerto Rico. That's fine.
Yeah. I wonder what we said to piss that one person off.
I don't think they lost their job.
I don't care. I don't care how many patrons we have. As long as we have a few, that means I'm loved.
I want to make 100 patrons.
It's a nice
round number.
No.
So once it gets 100, like it goes to 101, like, sorry.
Yeah.
Then you can't give us money.
Yeah. No, we want thousands of patrons. But
The more there are, the more anxiety it brings me. But I want you to have all the happiness in your life, Freddie. But at the same time, I'm like...
I like to know that... as many people as possible could be enjoying all this extra content we're creating. Yes.
And I'm constantly surprised at how many patrons like we have.
Yeah. We have so much bonus content. Yeah. If you like this show.
Got live on the back burner too.
Yeah. And there's even a couple things that are already recorded and just need a little little love as far as like, you know, imagery and all that stuff to go with them. But patreon.com/notlp, there is tons of stuff there. I think there's probably already hundreds of instances of bonus content available there.
Yeah.
And the more patrons means I get lunch every week.
That's true.
Once when did this start? I don't remember agreeing to this.
Well, it hasn't resumed yet because we're still paying off Indy's hotel costs, and then we got to pay for Columbus hotel costs.
You don't need to tell me what.
Well, people are curious probably where their money goes.
Yeah. You know where it goes? Goes up my nose.
Yeah, nose candy. And then
love cocaine.
And then we feed Andy with what's left. And then we pay these microphones.
It's not much because most of the money goes up Amy's nose.
Yeah. Thanks, patrons. You know what you're gonna pay for? You're gonna pay for all the cocaine I'm gonna smuggle up my toot toot on the Disney Cruise Line.
Your toot toot and your coot coot.
And my coot coot. I need to rewatch that episode of Broad City where she was smuggling weed up her vagina before going somewhere, because I am going to be on that Disney cruise for 7 days, and what would be better?
You're going to be on that show Locked Up Abroad.
Well, I'll do it on the ship. Oh, no, wait, the ships are, like, based out of...
Yeah. I hope you're so adorable if Mickey arrests you.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
And Goofy has, like, the Keystone Cops. He's got this baton and, like, walking, like, you know, running around, tripping over things.
So here's my question. There are a lot of rules and regulations, I'm sure, surrounding what Disney characters, if you're like full character person, that's your job, you're like Mickey or Minnie or Donald or whatever. Say you see something happening in front of you that is like assault or like a crime.
If you see Harvey Weinstein you know, coming towards you.
Yeah, like, is Mickey allowed to like break up a fight if like somebody's being killed or something? He has to
like playfully scold them by shaking his finger at him. Like,
would that be too much for a kid? Well, no, that would be good. Then a kid would see that.
But
Mickey's
what if it turns out
hero,
like the end of Stand By Me, where, you know, he gets stabbed in the belly and dies?
Oh, God.
I hope there's enough padding on that costume to absorb the stab.
Oh, what if Mickey's essentially bulletproof and knife proof? And like somebody has to keep trying to kill Mickey, and he just keeps coming at him.
Yeah, there's no person in there. He's like actually Jason. He's actually there.
That'd be amazing.
He's like a good, kind, wonderful Jason. These are things I like to think about. Uh-huh. What has Mickey? Well, okay, so one time I was in I was in Disney World as a kid, and we were watching a parade on Main Street in the Magic Kingdom, and I was definitely too far out into the road. And Captain Hook hit me on the head to get me to move.
With his hook?
I don't really remember. Okay, I just remember being horrified.
Or was it like the Apollo, Showtime of the Apollo, and he like took his hook and yanked you back?
I mean, I think his intention was to push me out of the way so I didn't get murdered by the float coming,
yeah,
which was nice. But he definitely hit me and hurt me. And I just still to this day feel really like deep shame. That had to even happen.
So it was Captain
Hook. Amy, why the fuck weren't you?
So is that movie a trigger now?
No.
You just feel a phantom pain every time you see Captain Hook?
Yeah, I definitely have PTSD.
She hears TikTok, TikTok. Yeah.
She can't even hear that Kesha song TikTok without going crazy.
And I'm like,
Well, it's so funny. Like, our friend Randy, he used to work at Disneyland as a dwarf,
right?
Yeah.
Which just still blows my mind if you know Randy.
I know.
And his personality.
As a matter of fact,
a job's a job. Military
way of thinking.
But he was telling us how, like, this kid, he was holding a baby and it threw up on him. I mean, he couldn't do anything. All he could do was, like, hold it outwards and hope they're away from his body.
That's great.
What is that I still feel like deep like embarrassment and shame over that, and I had to have been like 8 years old.
That's a deep-seated neuroses, Amy.
Well, nobody likes being told what to do, even if you're wrong.
Yeah,
because I got yelled at by Disney World a couple times.
Yeah, he did.
and it's still scarring.
You almost got us banned for life.
You're a bad person. Remember, I got yelled at too because I tried to get us all electrocuted in a thunderstorm.
What, during the pool?
Yeah.
Oh, we were still hanging.
I didn't want to leave the pool.
I'm like, Freddy, let's go. And you're like, yeah.
I'm like, it'll
be fine. I pay same as you.
And then she's like, seriously, you guys need to leave because people die all the time. Yeah. I'm like, what? They're like, no, seriously, every day someone here is struck by lightning.
Wow.
And I was like, for real?
It's Florida, bitch.
Yeah.
It's a lie.
I think they lied to us because, like, yeah, we saw lightning a mile away.
Yeah. No. Like, we really need a cigarette break. All them lifeguards hacking and wheezing.
Yeah. All right. Well, have we bantered?
Yeah, I feel thoroughly bantered.
No, okay, so I say congratulations to Blade Good Horror.
Oh, their, yes, yes, yes.
On their 10th anniversary celebration. That looked like a lot of fun.
I had serious FOMO.
Yeah.
But it just wasn't going to work out.
Yeah, I was actually going to go, but then I had to poop. So I couldn't go. No, it's like I was planning on going, but the night before, we came back from Mulaney, and me and Freddie finished off a thing of ice cream.
Uh-huh. I watched you do it, and I was horrified. Yeah.
And got home, you know, relieved myself. Then it got up in the morning just to get to see how I felt, to see if I was up to traveling for 6 hours, 8 hours to go to Milwaukee. And then I'm like, nope.
Nope.
So the Bloody Good people, they all got a giant group photo together with a statue of the Fonz, which at first...
Is it a zombie Fonz? Because I couldn't... No. It looked scary.
Well, at first glance, I thought it was Mark. And I thought he was wearing, like, blue leather pants. And it's really just a statue of the Fonz.
Fatherhood has changed him.
Yeah.
It made his skin metallic.
Yeah. Like, Mark, go outside. You live in Florida. Yeah. See the sun. Anyway.
It's a fun picture, though.
Yeah, those guys are a good group of ladies and gentlemen, and they deserve all the good things in this world.
So congratulations again.
Mm-hmm. All right, everybody. Well, we'll be right back with some news.
Just a minute, ladies and gentlemen. I think something is happening.
The people he kills get up and kill.
Partially devoured.
Remember, human beings are their food.
Welcome to this secret Facebook
group. Now my
chair's
creaking.
It's called Freddy's Dick Secret Facebook Group.
My dick.
It's basically just me and Andy on there talking about Freddy's dick.
My dick.
It ain't much to talk about. It's a minuscule group.
Yes.
We call it a micro group.
A group has tiny little Skittle balls.
Skittle balls!
I love Skittles.
Taste the rainbow, am I right?
He's mostly hair down there, guys.
Take a sniff. Pull it out.
This is gonna hit you when you pop it in your mouth.
That's Juicy Fruit, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Juicy Fruit will get right to you. Juicy Fruit, gonna move you.
I want some gum right now.
Yeah, I'm gonna gum in my juicy costume.
What'd you just say, Freddy?
Now my chair is creaking like crazy, too.
Then stop moving.
It's contagious.
I'm sorry.
Our chair's got arthritis.
Yeah.
Okay, let's talk about the news. I had to do it because Kelly's not here, so you're not going to get your fancy-dancy...
We're actually going to hear the headline for what it is?
Nonsensical headlines. I just came up with some stuff. Let's just live our lives, okay?
We're not going to hear the news in
Let's not compare me to Kelly.
You're not going to do it in a weird accent like he does?
Let's not say that I'm doing it way 100% better.
Mm.
Let's just say that it's like way 75% better. No, it is not. Mine is not. Oh. Yes.
Burn.
All right, everybody stand up.
I'm getting some WD-40 up in this bitch.
Oh, I can't wait. Okay, let's talk.
I wonder if the listeners can even hear the creak.
Sorry.
Do-do-do-do-do.
Dawson's Creek.
You know what that means? We need new chairs. So that means give us more money.
We do not need new chairs. Nah. Okay. Listen. Would you like to talk about some horror TV shows?
There's so much
right now.
Is it called the Squeaky Chairs?
Yeah.
No, that's the name, my band name.
No.
The Squeaky Chairs open for the Erratic Cornbreads.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Did you know? So the new Channel Zero season's almost done. I think it's got like one more
yeah,
episode.
We'll be we ready to marathon it.
Yeah, we'll marathon it. Channel Zero, No End House. It's on FX.
Right? What are people saying?
Or Sci-Fi.
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 What are people saying?
Oh, I don't know what people are saying.
Are people saying anything yet?
I've barely heard. I've heard a couple people like on Twitter mention it, but
yeah,
not a lot of chitter chatter.
Hmm.
I don't know.
What about pitter patter?
Inspired by Brian Russell's creepypasta tale. Channel Zero, No End House.
Did you say creaky pasta?
Mm-hmm. Tells the story of a young woman named Margot Slater who visits the No End House.
I don't know, Margot.
You don't know. No End, then. The No End House, a bizarre house of horrors that consists of a series of increasingly disturbing rooms. When she returns home, Margot realizes everything has changed. Mm. But I don't know.
So what is this show? I've never heard. Like I've heard about it. I've never seen it because I don't have FX because I don't have cable.
It's on Sci-Fi.
Sci-Fi.
Mm. Well, now you know
I don't have Sci-Fi.
You know somebody with
a password.
A password.
Yes. So what is the first season about?
What was that called?
Channel Zero.
Well, that's the name of
It was the kids' show.
It was a kids' show that only the kids could see, and there were things that happened in the past that were affecting
something. Cove.
Yeah.
Candle Cove?
Candle Cove.
Oh, that sounds fun.
It was good. There was some really creepy imagery. The tooth person.
Yeah. That's gross.
It wasn't like super fantastic or anything, but it was good.
It was definitely interesting.
I mean, I want to see this second one.
Totally worth seeing.
So is each season going to be like American Horror Story, where it's like a different plot?
Different creepypasta. Mm. Yeah. And that's the whole... the whole show thing is that it's based on creepypastas.
Okay.
Which is something I just want to punch every millennial for, a creepypasta.
I still don't know what it means.
It's cut and paste.
Cut and paste, and then there's the creepy stories, so it's creepy. It's so weird. I don't get it. I don't get internet language.
But why is it pasta? Because pasta's...
Taste.
It's pasta. Just a play on words.
Millennials, am I right? So we'll watch that, right, Freddy? When it
you know it.
Would you pay attention?
I am.
You have been on your phone this whole time.
What are you talking about?
With the art of conversation.
I've been on my phone.
Every time something creaks.
He's Googling squeaky chairs.
You have major ADD today.
I have not been on my phone other than to pull up one email that we're going to read. Think about it.
No more donuts before the show.
Oh, my God.
But they're so good.
All right, some more TV.
Mm.
Slasher season 2 is on Netflix. This shit just snuck up on me.
Yeah, is that a continuation of the first season?
It's all a new
story, right?
It's all new story. Did you see the first season, Andy?
Yeah, you guys told me about it. It's from Canada, right?
It's a Canadian television show. The first season starred Tori Spelling's douchebag husband, the Deanster. That poor girl. I think she's just stuck in a situation she shouldn't be in.
Mm-hmm. She had no chance.
She really
honestly
didn't. She reminds me a lot of Teresa Giudice.
Wait, who are you talking about?
Tori Spelling.
Oh, Tori Spelling. Never mind.
But it's hard to feel sorry for a person that has that, you know, access to money.
I know, yeah. But didn't she though, right?
Well, like I think she's waiting for her mom to kick off.
Oh, yeah, there you go. So Slasher season 2.
So Candy Spelling, watch out for stairs.
Bitch. If you see marbles falling down the stairs, yeah. It's over. Slasher season 2. The new season is called Guilty Party. And 5 years after concealing a murder, guilt-stricken summer camp counselors return in midwinter to the scene of their crime. Now a utopian commune.
So is this a continuation of the first one?
No.
Okay.
I just asked that question.
Oh, did you? Oh, I got ADD too. Is it more crispy? Is it more creepy pasta? Did I say it right?
That's something different. That was Channel Zero. This is Slasher. This is a completely different television show made by different people in a different country. I'm gonna murder everyone in this room. I think I'm gonna have to.
We're too distracted by the creaky chairs.
We should make there's going to be a season of Slasher called The Creaky Chair Killer. It's going to be me.
No, it's going to be me.
Spoiler alert.
I'm going to bash you guys to death with your creaky ass chairs. And then I'm going to WD-40 your eyeballs.
Mm-hmm. Oh, so when we blink,
it doesn't
you don't hear anything.
So those two, I haven't heard too much about, so I wanted to talk about those, Slasher and Channel Zero, but also The Exorcist, the new season's back.
It's very good.
It's very good. We're one episode behind right now, but I'm loving John Cho. I love John Cho. John Cho should be on everything, right?
He just showed up on Difficult People.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Made out with Billy Eichner.
He did.
He did.
He went a whole hog into that mouth.
Mm-hmm.
He put his whole hog in his mouth?
He's got a big mouth.
Stranger Things season 2 is coming in a week.
I just watched it, guys.
We got a whole Late to the Party coming at you for that.
Yeah.
You don't even know it. You probably don't even know what Late to the Party
we're
is.
We're Late to the Party about telling people about Late to the Party.
We're going to have two episodes of Late to the Party ready to go soon. And I got to get the first one out.
It's still where our favorite contrarian, Andy, doesn't want to watch something that people are enjoying because he's like, just because everybody's talking about it, I'm not going to watch it.
It's a little too pedestrian right now. I'll wait until it isn't cool.
Right. And then he watches something. That's basically it, right, Andy?
I'm not the only one that doesn't watch stuff right away.
Mm-hmm.
It's a commentary on how we watch TV shows now.
It's true. I didn't watch Breaking Bad till it was off the air for years.
That's true. And then, of course, Walking Dead season is starting, even though I've ducked out of that entirely. That's Freddy's. Yeah. Are you watching it, Andy?
I maybe got two episodes in the last season.
Yeah.
Then it just got... I'd need a break. I needed a break from it.
That's too dark.
Because it was too heavy.
It's too brutal. Yeah.
I'm curious. They say this season's going to be a big change from last season, and there's a big time jump. And they're going to fix a lot of things people didn't like about the last one, so we'll see.
Oh, I want to see the state of Coral's hair now.
Coral?
Eventually, it's going to be down to the floor.
Well, also, how are they going to age him up if they're jumping ahead so far? I wonder if it's not as far as they're saying.
I don't know.
He's going to have two eye patches.
Oh, that'd be great.
I stopped giving a fuck.
I know.
You know what? I set my boundaries. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And that show was encroaching on my watching too much brutality boundary.
Yeah.
I feel the same way about the Unabomber show you were watching.
Oh, but it's fun.
Yeah, but it was.
I need to finish that.
Watching those people get blown up was kind of upsetting.
It's on Netflix now.
This is a Unabomber show?
Yeah. It's like a fictionalized telling of how they, like, the investigation. What's Nuts is in it? From
Jake Sully.
It's Jake Sully.
Oh. Yeah. If you are one of us,
mm-hmm.
help us.
The dude from the Avengers is the bad guy.
The Vision.
Oh, yeah. Paul Bettany.
Yeah, he's the Unabomber.
What's that guy's real? Ted Kaczynski. He's playing Ted.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I like it because it's very 90s.
Yeah. It feels like the X-Files, but then somebody gets horrifically mangled up in an explosion, and you're like, oh, God!
So Freddy doesn't want to watch it anymore, so I'll watch it by myself.
Refresh my memory. How many people did he actually kill?
Several.
He injured a lot, too.
Yeah, he injured a lot of people, terrorized this very nation, really fucked some shit up. Jane Lynch plays Janet Reno, which is great.
Yeah. That's like perfect casting, actually.
Yeah. I really do wish they had gotten Will Ferrell to come back for that.
Though. It's a Discovery or a History Channel or something. Yeah. But now it's on Netflix, so you can watch it all.
It's good. But
it's not salacious, is it?
No.
Okay.
No.
It's pretty matter of fact and how they handle it? Okay.
Yeah, it's pretty straightforward. I
mean, it's very much dramatized.
They do add in some family drama for your lead detective character.
Some flavor.
Hatfields and McCoys was much better, though. If you're looking at a History Channel like style, like
retelling. Yeah, but I like serial killers.
Hatfields and McCoys is where it's at.
I like serial. I need to watch Mindhunter, although it is getting some... mixed reviews. I'm still in.
Tony loved it. Our friend Tony Wilson, we were out with last night.
And I trust Tony.
He said he binged it all at once.
I love the idea of it.
Yeah.
But it seems kind of like a slog.
I don't know.
Yeah.
I felt like the Unabomber show is a little bit of a slog.
Guess what? Living with you, being married to you.
It's a lovely slog, though.
Yeah.
I love slogging through life with you.
Every day's a blah.
Shut up.
She's just resigned to her life.
Yeah.
It's like, this is it, I guess.
Well, like Patton Oswalt in his special, a numb slog instead of a healing journey.
Yeah, numb slog.
Did you watch it with Amy? Oh, you
watched it last night. We each watched it on our own, yeah.
It was.
We don't like each other.
Yeah.
No. I love you, but I don't like you. You're a bitch, but I like you.
Oh, relationship goals, guys.
Yes.
It was good.
So moving on. That was all the TV news I have for you. Well, that's not true. There's one more in a minute, but we're going to mix it up with... Well, no, this is TV news too. Jesus Christ.
Well, that's where things are happening now.
That's where the shit's going. Peak TV, y'all. Here's my headline. Are you ready?
Mm-hmm.
50% of this sounds interesting.
Ooh.
Alfonso Cuarón.
I thought you were going to say Ribeiro.
Alfonso Ribeiro's triumphant return to television is Carlton.
Alfonso Cuarón and Casey Affleck.
Uh-oh.
Problematic.
Squeezy, grabby.
Working together to shop a horror TV series.
And the Oscar goes to...
Squeezy grabby. This is Squeezy Grabby's first win.
And his 10th grope.
Yeah, it's like... All right. So they're working on, they're shopping around a horror TV series about the origins of a cult.
Mm-hmm.
Affleck will be the star, and I will go, oh, thanks then. Here's the thing. And I know people come to this show for fun, but I have to throw in one rant, right?
It's expected at this point. They know what they're in for.
Fuck Casey Affleck. The minute you pay out money,
mm-hmm.
we're done. Why are we not talking about that as much?
What do you mean? Us in this room or people in general?
He paid out to two different women.
Mm-hmm.
And I understand that everybody's like, well, Amy, we know you love Ben Affleck, and why aren't you talking about him right now? Because I'm still processing that. I'm still processing
mm-hmm.
the accusations against Ben Affleck. Okay? But we know Casey Affleck definitely paid out to two separate women. So fuck that guy. Why does he still get to get Oscars and do all this crazy shit?
I don't think that's going to continue.
All right.
I think the worm has turned officially with the Harvey Weinstein case. And everything's going to be different. Small ways, but eventually in bigger ways.
Well, let's just face it. Hollywood is a brutal, gross place.
I mean, it is.
And I'm sure...
It's all about surface.
Yeah. And like it... We need to stop like putting people on pedestals.
Yeah, we do. Well, because as people, we will fail 100% of the time because we are people.
Yeah. Well, it's a Wild West kind of industry. More so than most entertainment in general is just finally, I think, and this is one of the positive sides of the corporate takeover of entertainment is that at least. I know, that's terrible. It's not very punk rock to say, but like an HR department has a good function. You should be able to go and be able to not worry about retaliation and report something that happens to you in the workplace.
But how many of these women have said, I tried to do that, and guess what? HR isn't there to protect the employee. It's there to protect the employer.
Well, that's what I'm saying. They need a real honest... When they take the personal... investment out of it where it's not the Weinstein company anymore and they actually fulfill that whole our corporate entity is more important than this guy's personal protection.
Yeah, but
that can be a good thing sometimes.
What was the thing about O'Reilly that just came out this week?
He just paid out $32 million. That was the settlement that he got hired again.
And
they rehired him. It's messed up.
Like why it Huh?
Yeah. But I think that if you can get, I think the whole leaning on companies like that by depriving them of your money is the best thing you can do.
It's all you can do. I don't know where this came from. I was looking at BuzzFeed list, who knows? And they were like tweets about all this Me Too stuff. And this woman was like, here's what men can do. Here's a list. Here's a pledge. And here's a list of things that men should do. And all of it was really good, except we get to do not go to strip clubs or pay for prostitutes. And I was like, what? Because some of these women that are stripping, sure, some of them have been abused and exploited, and that's where they are. But why are we assuming that's what... Why can't men go to strip clubs?
Mm-hmm.
Why are we demonizing sex workers? What did a sex worker do?
Is it because she feels like it's still objectification and it's still that's what they're
who's worth. We're allowed to objectify each other, right?
Maybe because that's what they're worth. She feels that's what their worth is based on, and that's fine to me, though.
If that's what you choose as your job, yeah.
Who made this list?
Some dumb bitch. And I'm like, you're just negating everything you're saying here. First of all, a little bit of it was like talky downy. Okay. Yeah. Men, this is what you have to do. Mm-hmm. Okay. Do not go to a strip club. I'm like, fucking why? Go to a strip club. Pay them. Be nice to them. Pay attention to the rules.
Yeah.
That's all.
Well, there should be only one rule in life. Don't be a dick.
And why can't...
The sad part is some people need to explain how not to be a dick.
Exactly. That's true. Some people do. Let's stop assuming all. But objectify each other. I don't care.
I love to be objectified. I wish I could be more objectified.
Objectify. I do not care. But do not violate somebody's boundaries. Do not hurt them.
Yeah. You can't define the boundaries for everybody.
Right. Don't go to a strip club. Why can't a dude go to a strip club? How is that bad allyship? I don't understand that.
So she has
you're gonna kill a stripper at the end of the night. That's bad.
Yeah, I think again it comes back to strip clubs also need good solid HR departments.
Yes.
That will enforce the rights of their workers.
A drug-free workplace.
A drug-free workplace.
I don't want anybody to be exploited. An abuse. But if you choose to be in a situation where there is some exploitation, that's different. It is a different thing. And this woman was also like, do not consume pornography that is violent. And I'm like, well, but what if the women are into that and they're making money off of it and that's what they've chosen to do? I'm just like, stop making everybody's choices based on what you're into. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, it's really got under your skin, huh?
It really did, because it bothered me. I'm like, why can't a dude go to a strip club? Yeah. I do not understand that.
Mm-hmm.
If you're murdering hookers at the end of the night, sure, I understand. Maybe that's a trigger. Don't go. And just whatever. So Casey Affleck, fuck you. And I guess Alfonso Cuarón, a little bit of a fuck you to you, sir. What's this? What's going on here?
A little fuck you.
Like a baby.
Just a little slap.
Right on your butt.
I'm sure he doesn't feel it's his job to enforce justice on Casey
Affleck. You're allowed to be friends with bad people, but you have to tell those bad people when they're doing bad things. Don't do those bad things. That's a bad thing, and our future friendship will be dependent on you not doing bad things.
Yeah, I found out something about somebody that we know right before the show.
We barely know this person. Let's calm down.
No, but it's enough of a
we've heard of
somebody who spoken we've, to we've once. Interacted with, and
I'm sure there's more of them out there too.
And even you know, promoted somewhat.
Yeah,
but we're not going to get into that because it's only one thing I heard. But now, don't you feel titillated with
Freddy? if there's one thing you should know about me, is like I love a rumor and I'll run with it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
he will. Do you know what I heard?
We need to cut the show right now. I need to hear all these rumors.
Here's what I'm gonna do, Annie.
I need to hear rumors about Fleetwood Mac. I love Rumor Willis.
Oh, her face is different now.
Whoops.
Okay, Freddie, in a minute. We're going to be done here in a second.
No, that's right. You can overhear Andy reacting to this in the background while you do your next thing.
All right. So Michael Jackson's back from the dead.
What? That's not possible.
I was trying to be very, like, tabloid.
Gotcha.
After the break,
mm-hmm.
Hear why Michael Jackson's beating on your window trying to get in and eat your children.
Mm. I can't react to this because I don't know who these people are.
Well, so when we take a break, we'll discuss it. All right. So have you heard about this Michael Jackson Scream album that was just released recently? Yeah, I haven't. It was like a compilation they just released.
And I just realized I shook my head at Amy and it's like, nobody can see that, Amy.
It's a compilation of like songs that are supposed to be like Halloween. It's supposed to be like a Halloween-y compilation.
Is Ben on there?
No.
Oh, fail.
The Thriller is.
Yeah.
Blood on the Dance Floor, Scream, Dirty Diana, Leave Me Alone. Uh-huh. Why is Somebody's Watching Me on here?
Is it really?
Uh-huh.
Did he also do a cover of that?
No, it says Rockwell underneath it.
But it's a Michael Jackson album?
Mm-hmm. It's called Michael Jackson Scream.
I don't understand.
Unbreakable, Dangerous, Ghosts. I don't know what that is.
Ghosts was the one of the last ones he did. They tried to do another like Thriller style video and Mick Garris directed it.
Oh, well, that's on there too.
It was never released, though.
That's out right now. So that, yeah. If you want to add that to your Halloween party rotation.
Some more problematic music.
Well.
Mm-hmm. I still listen to Michael Jackson.
I love Michael Jackson.
Well, here, you can innocently and with love in your heart support Michael Jackson now. He's dead. He can't hurt anybody anymore. So go for it.
I just don't
throw your money at it.
I just don't like all these people making me think about things.
Yeah.
Well, I don't want to give up Thriller. Yeah. Why do I have to give up Thriller or Captain EO? What did I do? Yeah.
Well, I think Thriller and Captain EO should be put in a museum because they're history.
What, are we not supposed to watch Pulp Fiction anymore?
I don't know. I don't know what we have to do it anymore.
What you've got to do is stop putting stock in entertainers. And stop looking to them as your heroes and your role models.
Right.
Because most of them suck as people. Mm-hmm. Most of them are self-centered, and all they care about is growing their selfish careers.
But I still want people to look up to and to put on a pedestal. I know we shouldn't
do that with?
I like heroes.
Yeah.
You know who I put on a pedestal? Chelsea Peretti.
You know what I put on a pedestal? The boozy.
The boozy.
I put the boozy on a pedestal. There are a lot of local heroes. There are real people out there.
Yeah, I know.
Find somebody who's doing something good and
we don't glorify educators enough. Yeah. We don't. Because they're not as sexy as... Yeah. as
hot for teacher begs to differ, Amy.
You know, there. If anybody else listens to...
I got my pencil!
We just sound like politicians now. Like, don't look at the local level for your heroes.
Yeah.
You can look up to entertainers, but recognize that they're not going to be perfect.
But take
the good.
It's just hard.
Don't take the bad.
Yeah. You take the facts of life, people.
The facts of life is, they say take the bad, but no. Don't take the bad.
But you have to take the bad. It's part of life, Amy.
Take your life lessons. So, give me somebody bad.
Anyone and everyone.
Bill Clinton.
Yeah.
All right. Turns out he's most likely a rapist. I didn't know that. I didn't understand that until very recently. Thanks to probably the Russians and the Trump campaign, I learned about that stuff. So, I got to give up Bill Clinton because that hurt. But then I can recognize all the good stuff he did do. And at the same time, he was probably using his power to exploit women a little bit for his own sexual needs. Okay. But he did do good things as a governor, as a president. Yes. He gave me Hillary. And then, you know what? She's done problematic shit. You know what? In her life, she's was not into gay marriage, and then she was. You know, she's was a problematic person, but at the end of the day, I think she could give more good than bad. Yeah.
And Trump's antics don't his the he stuff needs to die. He hasn't he done needs to die. Enough good to die. Counteract the bad.
Die horribly. Die with shit coming out of your eyelids. That's what I want.
Doo-doo?
Yeah.
And solid doo-doo.
I want like hard doo-doo nuggets to come squirting out of his eye sockets.
Like that hard poop that you pick up after your dog. After a couple of days.
When it's white?
Ooh. Yeah, it's rock hard.
I want yes. I want Elsa's granular hard
Speaking of dog dude, my sister the other day was like, I prefer picking up the warm dog poop as opposed to the ice cold stuff.
Bitch, what? Nobody wants to pick up warm dog shit.
She doing it with her bare hands?
No, with the bag, but like just you still feel it throughout the bag.
I have a scooper, one of those things where I don't even have to bend over.
But I kind of get what she's saying because it's just so weird to feel that ice cold hard dog duties.
There's nothing worse.
And you're afraid it's going to break through the bag and like, touch you. But there's no chance of like the warm, gooey stuff breaking through the bag.
But there is.
Bag, I mean.
It's happened to me.
It can squirt out like little holes.
Yeah.
Microscopic holes in your Kroger bag.
Gross.
Anything else? I have one more thing.
I don't even know what we're doing anymore.
In addition to Michael Jackson's Scream album right now, it has been announced that Michael Jackson's Halloween will air on CBS
Ooh.
On October 27th at 8 p.m. It's an animated show.
Who's voicing Michael Jackson? Bruno Mars?
Uh-huh.
Is he really?
No, I have no idea.
Oh, okay.
Two millennials meet accidentally on Halloween night and find themselves, along with Ichabod the dog, at a mysterious hotel located at 777 Jackson Street.
Yeah.
Called This Place Hotel. Once inside, Vincent and Victoria, that's their name, those millennials I spoke of earlier, are sent on an adventure culminating in a spectacular dance finale featuring an animated Michael Jackson.
Oh, I love this.
It's going to be like a return to Halloween specials now.
Yeah, mm-hmm. I hope so.
Yeah.
You know what I would like? To erase our history all the way back to 1985.
Such a simpler time. Yeah. The good old days.
Well, oh, you mean when people didn't have as many rights as they have now?
Yeah.
Maybe we were
better. MAGA.
Gotta make it great again. Remember when a white guy could just say the N-word in the streets? Do you remember that?
Yeah, now they don't say the N-word. Now they say SOBs.
And thugs.
We know exactly what you're saying, Trump, when you say sons of bitches.
Die.
Don't get it twisted.
Die, Trump. Die.
You wanted to say the N-word, but you didn't.
Burn.
But we know what you said.
Death on live television.
Ooh.
What's up, Secret Service? My name is Amy Morris, and I'm in Cincinnati.
I'll still pay for that, even if it was pay-per-view. I'll be like, guys. It's a big event. Let's go to my house. We'll have some pizza. Somebody
kidnap Melania and make him fuck a pig on live television.
Yeah, like a Black Mirror.
Somebody do it. I'm not going to do it, please.
The show is for entertainment purposes only.
Secret Service, what you need to understand about me is that I'm lazy.
FYE, for your entertainment.
For your entertainment. That's all the news I had.
That's good.
So we'll be right back.
What do you want from me?
Hello.
Hello?
Who's there? I'm talking. Hello.
Hello. Ghostbusters, what do you want?
Hello.
This is the last Ghostbusters with us.
The worst nightmare.
Now, wait a minute. Just hold on.
This is your wake-up call, pal.
Who is this?
It's me. Just want to know if you're wearing panties.
Slow down, what?
Whatever you do, don't fall asleep.
Put that cookie down! Now!
I'm in a coffin. I don't know where. Please help, I'm scared.
I will look for you. I will find you. And I will kill you.
The caller is in the house.
The calls are coming from the house.
What is the transmission?
Night of the Living Podcast wants to hear from you. Email us at crew@notlp.com. That's crew, spelled C-R-E-W. We're also on Facebook and Twitter as N-O-T-L-P, and on Instagram as Night of the Living Podcast. And now you can leave us a voicemail via telephone at 513-666-0916. Don't be shy. The crew may share your feedback on a future podcast. So if you want to keep it private, please say so in your message. Thanks for listening. And we look forward to hearing from you.
Help us, please! Come help us, we're trapped inside of here!
Right, well, I think if you were in trouble, you would have called the cops and not me. Now I got another call, okay?
Bye-bye.
Like one human pizza, half black, half Hispanic.
And we're back. We were just talking about Rick and Morty.
God, what a great show.
I know, but it's becoming... The whole Szechuan sauce thing really gamer-gated it a little bit.
You mean like the way people overreacted to McDonald's running out of sauce?
Some of the fans of Rick and Morty are in the group of problematics. Mm-hmm.
Dan Harmon came out and said, like, calm your tits, guys. Don't be dicks.
No, I think Dan Harmon is somebody that I do look up to.
Yes.
But you know what?
I'm sure he's done something, too.
One day he'll do something, but... As long as it's not murdering somebody or raping somebody or like slapping somebody, I'm going to be okay with him and as long as he apologizes.
Yes. And as far as I know, Justin Roiland hasn't said anything in defense of his writers yet, which is kind of disappointing.
Mm. So what do you got, Freddie?
Oh, what are we doing? Feedback?
I swear to God.
Is that right?
I'm gonna shove dog shit up in your eyelids.
It'd been nice. Heads up would have been nice.
I'm gonna put I'm gonna put cold dog dew under your armpits and let your body's heat warm them up. And then I'm gonna give them to Andy's sister.
I had a really nice email from Aussie Andy.
Oh, I'm sorry that it came after I said that.
Amy's a monster.
Uh-oh.
Here's Andy's email. Hi, guys. I felt the need to email you and say thank you for the show. Last Tuesday the 3rd, my mom passed away, and it was not unexpected, as she has been ill for a long time, but it still sucked. I have been listening to the NOTLP Origin shows, and they have helped me distract myself and not dwell on what has occurred. I have a ton of lovely memories about my mom, and I miss her so much, but I know she is in a much better place now. I have been listening to you guys for long now that I think about you as friends and in a way family. The funeral will be at the end of the month, and I have chosen to say a few words, and while that will be tough, it's something I want to do and my way of saying a final goodbye to mom. Thanks again for all the entertainment, Aussie Andy. That sort of stuff means the world to us, hearing that we could make somebody feel better during one of the worst times of their lives, because I get the same thing from doing this.
Yes.
Yeah, not to say, as much as we put into the show, I get a lot more out of it.
Yeah.
And like Freddy said, it makes it all worth it.
Yeah, it's nice.
And Aussie Andy, like, I'm sure, like, my mom and Freddy's dad and Kelly's parents, they had a nice welcome party for her up there.
Yeah,
and I think so. They are hanging out and listening to our podcast.
My dog Lucy and my cat Mona are there, and they're totally hanging out.
Yeah, and Zeus.
Did
and
your mom like
Zeus and Max?
They're did your up mom there like too. Pets?
Yeah,
I'm just gonna assume that your mom liked pets, Andy, and then Aussie Andy's mom liked pets. Yeah.
She used to call our old dog Zeus a miracle dog. Because she's like, he was so smart. Like, every time you come to the door, he brings your shoes to him, to you. Like, no. Like, Zeus just brought any shoe to the
closest. Miracle.
But she's like, she called him the miracle dog.
We also had, I had a message from Paul Gauthier. And we had asked him to comment on Not Scary Farm.
Is that Paulie G?
Paulie G. he says, comment on the last NOTLP show. Elvira's show was amazing.
It was the tits. All caps.
She does indeed still do the pasty tassel twirl with her breasts.
Oh, he says
breastises.
Her breastises?
She is still rocking an awesome body. I am convinced that she has an aging picture of her hidden away somewhere. But yeah, she. I need to take better care of myself.
Your titties?
And my titties. I wish that I could be.
My favorite part was when he said breasts.
Breasts.
Presses.
Just say tits and hooters like everybody else, Paul. Tits.
You got some big jumblies.
Boomies.
Boomies.
That's for you, Kelly.
Boomies.
Thank you, Paul, for that email.
Yes.
That was a Facebook message, and you can also reach us on Facebook in case you ever want to, or Twitter. Speaking of Facebook.
Or Instagram.
What about Instagram?
You can reach us there.
Yeah, we're Night of the Living Podcast on Instagram.
Not Snapchat. I don't understand it. So I don't want to be part of it. Go away.
Can we? Is that something we can blame them?
LinkedIn.
Yeah, can we blame the millennials for that too? Snapchat?
Yeah, that's where they are.
I don't know
where they are.
My thing is, I don't know any millennials, and I don't know what their MO is.
What's the after millennials? The youngers? What are they called?
The youngers.
So the young, I have a coworker who has a younger, she's like 16 or 17 or something, and they were going on a cruise, and she was very insistent that they pay for Wi-Fi on the ship because she had a Snapchat streak she didn't want to break. I'm like, the fuck?
Well, I'm offended that we don't get free Wi-Fi on the Disney cruise, not because I want to use my Wi-Fi, it's just the fact that it's not free.
Right.
Because they're milking us left and right.
They are. They're going to pull your nipples out immediately.
That's how hard they're milking me.
And tuning in Tokyo.
Looks like our international listeners are getting their shirts and pens in the mail.
Awesome.
Blake sent us a photo
of his pen. Who?
Balake. Where is he at? What international community?
He's in
Canada?
El Paso, Texas. How about that?
That is far away.
So I don't
know
why.
That's practically Mexico.
I don't know why he's just now getting that. When I first saw his post.
I think his post meant that late as in posting, not when he received it.
Oh.
It's very exotic where he lives.
Yeah. That's Blake in Texas, Blake.
Balake.
That's Balake. So I don't know if our internationals are getting them yet.
I don't know how long that takes.
I sent them out. I sent them all out last week, except for Connor's. But Connor's, you should be going out very soon.
Where is Connor at?
Ireland. Did I say that right?
Did you guys enjoy your hurricane? Ireland,
yeah. Not Scotland.
Did you guys enjoy your Irish hurricane? Isn't that crazy?
It is crazy. An Irish hurricane sounds like some sort of terrible mixed drink.
That's Bailey's and rum.
A Bahama Mama.
That sounds good.
Bailey's and rum. Mix it up and put a fucking cherry on it.
Didn't we send something to Scotland?
I don't know. What do I look like?
I thought we did.
Somebody looking at a list? I think
our friend Andrew lives in Scotland, right?
Yeah, I just thought we mailed something there. Anyway, we want to thank Ben, who sent us a care package from Australia. Yeah. It has some pretty awesome stuff in it.
Thank you, Ben.
Tim Tams, Walla Walla Bing Bangs.
Some problematic cool candy books. Called Redskins.
And there's
which
also...
Which are delicious.
That was really good. Yeah. Me and Andy split one of those. I think it pulled out all my fillings. Thanks for being patient on the Boo 2. We saw Boo 2 Thursday.
And everybody was too tired to record about Thursday. And then Friday, we were too tired to deal with it. And last night, we were fucking too tired.
So we're going to try to get Mikey B on the phone so we can do it.
Did you text him?
I will.
All right. So anything else before we wrap this monstrosity?
I'm sure there is something, but I forgot because I'm getting old. Along with my chair.
No.
I'm squeaky, guys.
Old Andy.
Squeaky Frome.
She's still in jail?
I think so.
Yeah.
Is she alive? Did she get the grease?
Mm-hmm. What?
Squeaky wheel gets the grease. Bad joke, but, you know, that's what I'm made of.
So if you are a patron of this show at the Beelzebub level, we love you more. Than our other children, because we only have so much love to give.
We monetize our love.
Yes. We will. You are the ones we consider producers of this show. We want to thank you by name, Adam.
Thank you.
What
think we were waiting for something, because Kelley always says something.
I want you to fill in. Yeah. Brooke.
Kelley always says something. Brooke. Each name.
Hey, all right, Brooke.
Does she babble?
Ernest. Ernie.
Ernie.
Earn those E's.
Alberto?
Yeah.
That's what you got? Albert. Looking good in that shirt, sir.
Looking good in that shirt, yeah. Albert. That rhymes.
Eddie?
Eddie Spaghetti.
Tree is Alex.
The tree is also the name of the hero in...
Happy Death Day.
Happy Death Day.
And tree is also our hero.
Mm-hmm.
Are you problematic too, though, girl? You can tell me. Brandon Boone,
boy did I kill him hard. And Friday, and I'm looking forward to killing him in Call of Duty World War II, yeah. When it comes out,
and I can't wait to see when you come in your costume.
He's gonna come in his costume, yeah.
We got Bill in New York City, whom I met, and he's lovely.
Bill. I'm not good at improv, no. Guys.
We already talked about Balake, so we're not talking about him anymore. No, sir. You cannot have more of our time, Blake. Mark Watts. We met you that one time.
Flying Pig Mark.
Flying Pig, mm-hmm. Mark. Michael Powell.
Aha!
Whorehound Weekend Mikey. That's what we call you.
Zing!
Zing zong!
Woohoo!
Mikey P.
We need to come up with a... Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes. All right, you're Mikey P. Everybody gets a nickname that's yours. Jeremy Burmeister.
The Berm.
The Jerbier.
The Eister.
It's Carrie and Jassy.
Carrie and Jassy.
Alice Wallace. Yeah, thanks for taking care of our ill and villain.
Kelly's our villain.
K to the com.
K to the com. What is Kelly's bully name?
Oh, Smelly Cum Stink.
Smelly Cum Stink. Amanda. Commanda, as I like Amanda to call you.
Amanda Hugging Kiss.
Commanda.
And Jimmy B.
B. A lot Jimmy of bees, B's huh? Sausage.
Hmm?
A lot of bees.
Yeah, well.
Peas.
We got bees in her bonnet. Anything else? Live show, October 30th.
Yep. Make sure if you can make it, or if you know someone local who you think would enjoy a kick-ass Halloween experience.
cocktail.
Great cocktails.
Just a relaxing night filled with learning and laughter.
Learning and laughter. Mostly laughter.
Freddy's got some facts to drop.
I do. I have some fun trivia about the history of Halloween.
This could be a quiz after.
Yeah, sure.
We'll probably might give away a couple t-shirts or something.
Yeah, we'll probably have some stuff to give away.
We should get a t-shirt cannon.
Oh, yeah. I want one of those so bad.
In that small space.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
Some of the best bartending staff you'll find anywhere at the
Overlook
Lounge.
They were just written up in something good.
They've been in everything.
The Overlook's fantastic.
They've been in Playboy magazine. I think they were in
Your Heart.
I think New York Times. True. All kinds of places. Time.
They're like media sluts.
Yeah.
It's a place worth a little extra driving to come and enjoy. I know it's a Monday night and that sucks, but the next day is Halloween, so come get in the spirit.
It's a cozy place.
Yeah.
I would love to see it jam-packed full of people.
What's in the writer's block? I always get that, and I like it.
There's like bourbon and some other stuff.
It's real good.
Yeah, it's good.
Anything else before we go?
I hear someone at the door.
Someone's at the door.
I think it's my shoes.
Freddy's shoes are here. Those are his water shoes for the cruise.
Water shoes for the cruise. I'm going to go check on those. Stephen King month, right? Return of the King.
We'll probably start with Gerald's Game, or
sure, because it's easy to get.
Yeah,
I like easy things.
Like yourself?
Yes.
How easy you are, dirty slut.
Yeah. When I walk by, it's like whistling a cave. You know?
Whistling through your butthole.
Yeah.
Sounds about right. All right, bye everybody.
Frankenstein was wondering if he should go to bed when his old body.